Preparation of the crude drugs. Preparation of the crude drugs from MEPS. Crude drugs is a plant or animal drug occurring in either the fresh or dried condition and either whole or reduced in particle size by cutting or grinding. Thus, its preparation involves collection, preservation, storage, grinding, and use of specific techniques for preparing other forms of drugs. Collection. The collection of plant material for crude drug requires knowledge of plant as well as its parts useful for medicine. Suitable time for collection, the part or whole plant collection need to be done in a specific time as the amount of its constituents are not constant throughout the life of the plant. Thus, plants should be collected at appropriate time. Sometimes the collection at wrong time leads to not use the material. Rules for collection. Usually plant is collected at the time when it has reached its optimal growth. Bark is collected in the spring. Root and rhizomes are collected at the end of the vegetative period. Leaves and halves are collected at the flowering stage. Flowers are collected when fully developed. Fruits and seeds are collected when fully ripe. Methods of collection. Medicinal plant must be largely collected by hand, especially for wild plants. For cultivated ones, we may use harvesters, but in some cases, manual collection is unavoidable. For example, collection of barks. The manual collection of plant requires large labor costs, so rising the price of the crude drugs. Preservation of the plant material. To prevent changes in the active compounds of plant, the plant material need to be preserved during transport and storage. When plant dries, various chemical changes may occur by oxidation or hydrolysis or pathogens. Preservation aims at limiting those processes as possible. The preservation includes drying, air freeze, stabilization, and fermentation. Drying, the most common method of preservation. Enzymatic processes take place in aqueous solution. Rapid removal of the water from the cell will therefore largely prevent degradation of the cell constituents. Drying also decreases the risk of external attack by molds or other pathogens. The stop the enzymatic processes, the water content must be brought down to about 10%. Drying must be done quickly. It can be air drying or freeze drying. Air drying. It can be done in the field by simply keeping the material spread at the air refresh, or can be done by use of air dryer. While using air dryers, the temperature of the air is kept at 20 to 40 degrees for thin materials and 60 to 70 degrees for harder and thick parts. In dry drugs, the enzymes are not destroyed but only rendered inactive due to the low water content. As soon as water is added, they become active again. Hence, dried material must be protected from moisture during storage. Freeze drying. Drying with the help of freeze is mild processes. Frozen material is placed in an evacuated apparatus which have a cold surface, maintain at minus 60 degree to minus 80 degree. Water vapors from the frozen material then passes rapidly to the cold surfaces. This method requires a relatively complicated process and is much more expensive than hot air drying. It is important for drying heat sensitive substances. Stabilization and long storage enzymatic reaction will slowly destroy the constituent because the last traces of water can never be removed. This method is useful for isolation of compounds that are very susceptible to enzymatic degradation. The most common method is brief exposure of the plant material to thionyl vapor under pressure 0.5 atmosphere. In order to avoid this degradation, the enzymes should be destroyed before drying, a process usually called stabilization. Fermentation, the process of acylation of enzymatic process by keeping the materials in thick layers, often exposed to raised temperature 30 to 40 degrees and humidity. This process is mostly used to remove bitter or unpleasant tasting substances or to promote the formation of aromatic compounds with a pleasant smell or taste. It is mainly applied to drugs used as feces or stimulating agent, example vanilla tea. Storage of the crude drug. The stability of the crude drugs determine the storage method. Usually the stability of crude drug varies greatly. Drug containing glycosides and esters are usually less stable than those containing alkaloids. During with drugs with essential oils deteriorate rather quickly through evaporation, oxidation, and polymerization of the substances constituting the essential oil. Tannins, on the other hand, have an almost ultimate durability. It is also necessary to protect the drug against insect attack. Thus, crude drug is stored in a cold and dry places. Grinding of the crude drugs. Some crude drugs need to be prepared solution or powder grinding is performed. Grinding can be performed with the help of machines, hammer, mill, knife, mill, tooth mill. After the formation of the powder, sieving and the blast sifting is performed. Heat sensitive materials are grinded via cold grinding or by cooling mills with liquid nitrogen.